Pop star Sting is coming to the UK.
Our Ship tells the story of a community facing the demise of the shipbuilding industry in Wallsend, where Sting grew up. Let's take a look at the cast rehearsing a song from the show.
Sting is here, but Sting is here.
Good morning.
And you were here really early this morning. Appreciate that.
I managed to get out of London before the blizzard completely took us over, but I was very happy to get to Manchester last night. The weather here is mild compared with London.
Yeah, you may be here a while.
Never mind.
You say that right.
And we're not going to talk about weather all the way through, but we're focusing in on the northeast because that's been really badly hit by the weather at the moment. Of course, that is where the musical is set.
It's where I'm from.
Yeah.
I'm from a little town called Wallsend, which is in between the North Sea and Newcastle. We were famous for building ships. Actually, the biggest ships ever constructed on planet Earth were built at the end of our street. And it was an amazing, surreal industrial environment to grow up in. I was born and raised there. And the dimensions of the place were very theatrical. So one day I thought, yeah, maybe I should write a play about my hometown, about my community.
And just set that in a bit of context for us. So it's something it was a thriving industry when you were very young. It was still in existence.
Yeah.
And then what happened next?
I watched thousands of men walk into that shipyard every morning past my front door, and I watched the same men walk back home at night. And as a kid, I'd wonder whether that was going to be my future, because there's very little else in the town. I didn't want it. I had other dreams. You know, I wanted to be a musician and a songwriter. And then those dreams came to fruition, obviously, but thankfully. But I always remembered the environment I was brought up in and the community I was brought up in. What happened to that community in the 80s when the shipyards were closed down for economic reasons, which are very abstract. And so I wanted to tell a story in my community, and I thought I was ideally placed to do that because I'm a singer-songwriter, but I'm also from that community. So The Last Ship is really the story of that community.
And when that sort of industry stops, it has an impact on, a sort of devastating impact on lots of different people.
I think the town's identity was wrapped up in the industry. They're incredibly proud of those ships they built. And they actually built things with their hands. We don't do that anymore. So there's a bit of nostalgia there. I don't really have any answers. But for me, the basis of economics is community. That's, without community, it doesn't make any sense to me. So I think music and songs have a very, very important role to play in economic hard times, political dark times. Give people a smile, give people some hope, give people some uplifting feelings.
I can't help but notice that one of the stories we're reporting on today is about car manufacturing in the UK worries about, I mean, this is linked to Brexit, we won't get involved in that. But I mean, all I'm saying is that those issues, this is a major industry where a lot of people, potentially, their jobs are at risk. I mean, these are ongoing issues, aren't they? It happens to be about shipbuilding in that area.
It will resonate with people everywhere. We're playing the whole of the north of England. Every town has this story. What happens when your industry goes? Who are you? I don't really have the answer, but I've got a lot of questions.
Mm. Another way that you arrive with your guitar, does it go everywhere with you?
It's my prop.
Come on.
No.
You're going to play
it later.
Yeah, I know, because you were here at 5:15 this morning rehearsing, weren't you?
I was.
How much do you still enjoy songwriting?
That's my job. I love finishing a song, but I don't like looking at a blank page in the morning thinking, how am I going to fill that one? But when you're inspired, when I was inspired to write about The Last Ship, the songs poured out of me as if they'd been locked inside for a long time. So it's been a wonderful adventure for the last 7 years. You know, Broadway, I saw the play in Helsinki last month. So it has a life, but to take it back to Newcastle, to the theatre I began my professional career at, is amazing. I started in the pit of an Andrew Lloyd Webber musical called Joseph Technicolor Dreamcoat.
I remember Joseph Technicolor.
I was playing the bass,
yeah.
And now I'm going back as the gaffer. So it's kind of an amazing circle.
That is extraordinary. So was that your first, was that your first job?
Was it your first professional job as a musician. Getting 60 quid a week at the time, which was amazing.
But it must be strange, because presumably quite a few of the guys who were with you in the pit then, must be one of their stories they tell. Is that, do you know, I was in the pit that time and Sting was playing bass.
Yeah, they may be telling that story.
It's weird, doesn't it?
What happened to Sting? Where did he go?
Yeah, what about him? Now, can I ask you about longevity in the music business? You clearly have that.
Why would I know?
Yeah, I'm trying to ask it delicately, but I'm mindful of the Rolling Stones who just announced they're doing another UK tour.
Yeah.
They've been doing quite a bit of publicity talking about their relationship over the years and also about the stuff they got up to. I mean, they talk fairly openly about all sorts of things, do lifestyle and drugs.
I'm not going to talk about it.
No, I know. I'm not going to ask you to talk about them. I'm just talking about you and how you have sustained yourself.
I'm really led by my curiosity. And I love surprises. I want to be surprised. When I compose music, I want to surprise people. When I choose the kind of music I'm going to do next, I want that to be surprising. It's the most important element of music. It keeps me occupied. I have no reason to stop, and I will keep doing it until I'm too stupid and old to do it anymore.
Tell us about you've got a new album with Shaggy, is that right?
Well, that's a surprise, right?
Exactly, exactly.
Why is Sting singing with Shaggy? He's a dear friend of mine. We made an album together last year. It's coming out in April. It's really a love affair between Jamaica and Great Britain. It's very reggae. So it's a surprise, and it's an uplifting record.
I think we're seeing a little bit of this here. I presume this video from Singles.
Oh, we went to Kingston, Jamaica, yeah. We were there over Christmas.
And how was that collaboration for you? Whose idea was it? Was it just one of those things that happened naturally?
It just kind of happened, you know. We knew each other, we started singing together, and I love the sound of his voice. Whenever he starts to sing, the energy comes up. He's a very special man.
Interesting, because obviously you're from here and all the rest of it. You lived so much time in America. Where do you like being?
Well, home is where my wife is, and she's in New York at the moment. She went to New York last night, so I'll join her tomorrow.
Yeah.
So that's home.
That's a nice way of putting it, isn't it? Home is where the wife is.
Do you know when the first time I saw the Police play was 1979.
Don't be ridiculous.
It's this Reading Rock Festival, 1979. Do you remember it?
No.
That's exactly what I quoted you just said.
I don't remember it at all.
I do remember it. Yeah,
because it was a time you were kind of 2 years into what was extraordinary.
Yeah.
You know,
we headlined Reading Festival, it was a big deal.
Do you really remember
that? Of course I remember it. I remember those early gigs much more than I remember the later ones.
Special. With like a positive glow around it?
Yeah, absolutely. No, it was an amazing adventure.
Yeah.
A long time ago.
Yeah.
The show.
I tell you what, from where I was, it was all pretty grim. You probably had it all laid on nicely at backstage.
Not necessarily, no.
Charlie remembers it extremely well. Thank you very much. So you're going to be here just in about, 15 minutes time or so, and you're going to be playing for us.
I'm going to be singing a song with Richard Fleischman from the show. It's called The Night the Pugilist Learned How to Dance. Just me and him.
Excellent.
I'm going to be his guitar player.
Excellent. Thank you very much. It's lovely to see you.
Thank you very much.
Good luck.
This morning, delighted to say, I had a chat a little earlier. Now, he's going to play for us.
Yes, he is here with Richard Fleischman, performing a song called The Night the Pugilist Learned How to Dance from his new show, The Last Ship. And here they are.
In the streets around here, there was nobody tougher than me. See, I was quick with my fists and fast with my footwork, as you can plainly see. But a girl is attracted to skills more refined than the pugilist art, and so I incline to take myself serious as a modern romancer. And I secretly learned all the moves of a dancer. You swing to the left, then you swing to the right. Keep your eyes on your partner like you would in a fight. You just keep to the rhythm and follow the beat. The important thing is never to look at your feet. And then a miracle's happened, and your mind's in a trance. Though the strategy's subtle, retreat and advance. It's all about attitude, all in your stance.
Attention to detail, leaving nothing to chance, which explains how the pugilist finally learned how to dance. In a bar where the strategist's bridges were burned, where it seemed that his fortune had suddenly turned, was the night when the scrapper was suddenly dapper, and this poor fellow's heart was still going like the clever's. The night that the pugilist finally learned how to dance.